Welcome to the testing world. So previously we have seen few approaches in which we are going from parent to child, child to parent, we are moving siblings, it's a following sibling and preceding sibling. Now I'll show you how we can locate element by using multiple approaches, by using many syntax together, like I'll move to the parent, then child, then we are moving to the sibling. So let me show you the scenario first. I'm on the Facebook page. I'll just refresh it. Yeah. So I'm able to locate this username text box. So I'm able to locate this, but if you check it, that's a password text box. And I'm taking example, I'm not able to locate it. So I'll try to locate password through username. How we can do that? Okay. If I'm able to locate username, I'll move to the parent of it, which is TD. Then I'll move to the following sibling, which is again TD. Then I'll move to the child of it. So we are using parent, then following sibling, and then child. Let me show you how we can write it. So first of all, I'm writing input where ID is equal to email. Means I'm able to locate that username box, which is this. I want to move to its parent, which is TD. So I mentioned like parent colon colon TD. So now I'm here on the TD. I want to move its following sibling, which is again TD. So I mention following sibling colon colon TD. And one thing need to be noticed, after this we have two following siblings which are TD. I want to go to the first one. So I just mention first. Now in this TD, go to its child, which is input. Whenever we are going to child, it just mention input. So that is the way in which we have locating a password box through username. Let me show you here, and it matches with the one element. If you check it, that is highlighted. So we are able to locate an element by using parent, child, sibling, all these approaches in a single case. So again, if you check it HTML, I'll show you it again. Input, that's element which I'm locating. I'm just moving to the parent of which is TD. Then I move to the next sibling, which is again TD, and then child of it. Okay, let's do the reverse of that. I'm able to locate this password box. So I'm writing like input and where ID is equal to, and the ID here is, sorry, this one, which is pass. Okay, I'm taking example when I'm able to locate password box through password, I want to locate username. And these are the example when we are not able to locate element directly. So we are writing the complex XPath to locate it in some reference. So I'm able to locate this password. I just want to move to its parent, which is TD. So I mentioned parent colon colon TD. Then I want to navigate to its preceding sibling, which is TD again. And we have only one preceding sibling, so we need not to mention one or two. Preceding sibling colon colon TD. And through this TD, I'll move to the input. So child of it, its input. So when we are directly moving to the child, just forward slash, it will move to the child. I'll just copy this. Let me show you here. And yes, we are able to locate username through password with the reference of password. So here we have seen how we can make complex XPath by merging many techniques together. So all these techniques that we have gone through can merge together. Our syntax should be correct. That's all we have for this session. Here we have seen how we can write complex XPath. That's all we have. Thanks for watching this video.